Hey everyone, welcome to this episode of the Connect series. My name's Nick Smith. I'm here with Michael Hollister. He is from our R&D team working on our 15.4 stack at sub-gigahertz and 2.4 gigahertz. I'm actually very excited about what you're showing today. Anytime we dig one of you R&D guys out of the back rooms where they hide you, it's really cool, especially because you in particular designed and implemented this feature that we're going to talk about. So thank you for joining.
Oh, thanks, Nick. Glad to be here.
Yeah. So today we're talking about a feature that you implemented in our 15.4 stack in our SDK called Turbo OAD. Can you tell us two things quickly? What exactly is the 15.4 stack? There is a video on that that you can go back and get more detail. And number two, what is OAD?
Okay, sure. The 15.4 stack is an out-of-box networking stack that TI provides to enable star topology networks running typically on sub 1 gigahertz frequencies. Okay. Now, OAD, or over-the-air download, is a device firmware upgrade process that allows you to update your devices on the network over the air.
Okay, and now you've implemented a feature called Turbo OAD. So can you tell us a little bit how Turbo OAD is different from more of what a traditional OAD would look like?
Sure. So Turbo OAD is an extension to this 15.4 OAD protocol that allows you to deploy Delta software updates. A Delta update is essentially an update that contains only new or changed content in your software version. And the benefits of doing this is that you reduce the amounts of time, bandwidth, and power required to deploy the updates.
Okay, yeah, I assumed in the name Turbo OAD you would get some kind of speed benefit. So if I understand correctly, what you said is basically instead of just updating the full image, you're looking for the differences and only updating the new pieces of
code.
That
is correct, yes.
And that helps you with both the time it takes to do the OAD and then subsequently the power consumption of your system.
That is correct.
Okay, yeah, because I guess OAD operation in some cases can be very time and bandwidth consuming and thus high power.
Absolutely. Typical software updates may only contain like a collection of bug fixes or small new features. So the less data that you have to transmit over the air, the faster your updates can be.
Okay. And what situations would the Turbo OAD most benefit your system overall power performance?
Well, it depends really on the type of update that you want to deploy to your system. For usually small updates or just your typical software updates, it actually works very well in most cases. You can, on average, expect anywhere from 50 to 80% reduction in time it takes to transmit your updates. So it works in a fairly general, broad use of case.
Okay, cool. Well, do you want to get into this demo, show me what it can do, tell me how it works, and just walk us through it?
Sure, absolutely.
Awesome.
So the demo setup that we have here is we're going to do a head-to-head speed comparison of using OAD versus Turbo OAD. So we have two networks here, sub-1 gigahertz networks that we're running on our 15.4 stack and using a data rates of 50 kilobits per second. Now we have two identical networks in front of us, but these are separate, so they won't be able to communicate each other during the OAD download.
Okay.
So on the left-hand column here, we will be using OAD to transmit the updates to our sensor device, and on the right-hand side, we'll be using Turbo OAD. Now, as far as the hardware goes, we have two Linux gateway devices that we'll be using to host our collector application. And these devices will be distributing our updates. And these are running on our BeagleBone Black devices. And then connected to the BeagleBone Blacks are the network processors. And then finally, the sensor devices.
Okay.
So these will be receiving our updates.
And a quick question. You mentioned we're running this, you know, via Linux gateway. But am I correct? Is the Turbo OAD feature, that's a stack feature. So you can be running just a sub-gig network, a gateway to an IP network, an embedded gateway, doesn't matter. It's a stack feature that does the Turbo OAD.
That is correct. At least out of box for our TI, for our SDK, the process for deploying an over-the-air update, we use our Linux Gateway SDK. Okay. So that's at least the process that we support currently to send a Turbo OAD update.
Gotcha.
All right, so I think that wraps up most of the hardware. And as far as what we have now on our computer here is we have our demo web application where we can now issue the updates to the sensors nodes we have on the network. So on the top, we have our web application. And on the bottom, we have our sensor outputs in which we can see the sensor statistics as well as the software version that is running on the sensor. So at this point, we have the whole demo set up. We have the files that we want to distribute to the nodes. So I think we're ready to get started. So Nick, would you like to give a countdown so we can start the comparison?
Sure. 3, 2, 1, go.
Go. Okay, I'm gonna wait for this to actually start first. It takes a second or two before. Okay, now I'm starting. So the last one was regular OAD.
Okay.
And the right one will be Turbo OAD.
Yeah, I really like being able to see this head to head.
Exactly.
It's pretty cool.
So if you just look at the output on the screen here, just notice how fast we're transmitting our updates. And if you notice closely, the amount of data that we're transmitting is only 6.5 kilobytes for this update.
Yeah.
Whereas when we're sending the full binary image, it's over 106 kilobytes.
Wow. Yeah, and the Turbo OAD is already complete.
And it's already booted up into the new software version 2.
Yeah.
What you can see here is that we've achieved over a 90% reduction in time it took to distribute this update.
Wow.
And the thing to keep in mind as well, imagine if you're using a slower data rate, such as 5 kilobits per second, for low rate, long range or low power, or for that matter, if you have more of a typical network size of 50 to 100 nodes, the time savings you're gonna get is just significantly multiplied by using Delta updates.
Absolutely, yeah, and I'm thinking of applications like, you know, say you have a thermostat, a Wi-Fi connected thermostat that's talking to, you know, remote temp sensor nodes all over a building or home. A lot of times that back end network is a sub gig network and those are very low power sensors. So while you can afford to do the OTA fairly easily on the Wi-Fi link, to do the OTA over the sub gig link, a 90% reduction could actually be very significant to these small battery sensor applications.
Absolutely.
Yeah. No, this is a very cool demo, and I hate to wrap it up while this thing's still chugging along, but I think it'll kind of drive the point
home. It'll
still
be another minute or two before it finishes up. We're only at 60% here.
Yeah, so it's significant. So Michael, I really appreciate you coming on and showing this demo. This is one of the cooler ones. I just enjoy the head-to-head aspect of it. Now, if people want to get started and start playing with the Turbo OAD for themselves, is it available now? It's in the SDK?
That is correct. It's in our latest SimpleLink SDK and as well as our TI-15.4 stack Linux Gateway SDK.
Okay.
And with that, you can use our OAD examples and documentation to learn how to enable this feature and use it in your system.
Okay, so ti.com/SimpleLink, you can get to the SDKs from there or dev.ti.com. And again, Michael, I really appreciate you being here. This is a great demo. Now that we know what kind of demos you have hidden away, we're going to have you on again. All of you guys, thanks for joining. Please go check out Turbo OAD. It's a very cool, unique feature in our SDKs. As always, we have a lot of great videos coming up for you. A lot of cool things happening in the world of automotive, industrial, building automation, a lot of good videos. Thank you guys. As always, go to ti.com/SimpleLink to learn more about these devices. Take care.